Hello, folks, I'm back. I made it. I survived the weekend. It was a wonderful tour on the west coast of Canada, but I'm back home now and I feel good. I'm tired. I'm getting over jet lag, but that's no excuse. Today, we're going to get right into something that's a little bit interesting, and the reason why we're doing it is because a good friend of our channel, Troy, has asked a question. Is there any way to just get the bottom note when playing chords? Scenario, I'm playing live chords on key synths or whatever on an instrument track, and he has a separate track that with a bass instrument on it, and he just wants the bottom note of the chords he's playing on the one track to feed into the next track. So to explain that a little bit further, say on this track called Galileo, he's going to be playing chords, all right? This is a live situation. He's going to be playing the main chords of the song. He wants it so that automatically on another track, there's a bass instrument loaded and it's just reading the bottom note of those chords and playing along with him. So that way, no matter what he does, he's getting a bass line and the chord. So if, for example, if I'm doing this, I'm playing an A minor, it'll take the A from the A minor because it's the root note, play it through this track, and then you'll have a note like this, right? So it's more like this. Okay, well, I'll say this, Troy, this is not a perfect solution. I'm wondering if you've come to this same conclusion or not, but take a look at what I did. Maybe this will help you out. And of course, other folks, if you're watching this and you have an idea, definitely leave it in the comment section below and we'll update the video for future purposes, okay? All right, let's start the show. Okay, so basically all I've done is I've loaded up an instrument track and I've record armed it, and on that instrument track I loaded up a polysynth with a preset called Galileo. I don't know why I chose that one, but it sounds all right. Right, not too abrasive, not too soft, and it'll do just fine. I've set the input of that channel to this shitty little Key Rig 49 that I'm using by M Audio. I actually ran this keyboard over with my car. Can you believe that? I was running out to band practice. I was in a hurry. I leaned the keyboard up against the passenger side of my car. I forgot something in the house. I ran in the house, ran back out, jumped in my car, started it, and just peeled out of the driveway, and I felt kerclunk, and I thought, shit. And I looked and there was my M Audio Key Rig 49 laying on the ground. I had run it over and it still works fine. Like, it's not even cracked. Nothing about it is broken. So that's pretty amazing. I got this thing for $30. Anyway, okay, so I've loaded up an instrument track with Galileo there, and that's it. Typical, you know, loading up an instrument on an instrument track. Okay, so then I loaded up another track. And on this one, I put a bass instrument and I put the input to nothing. There is no input. But before the instrument, which is the polysynth bassline one, which is a polysynth with a preset bassline one, I put a note receiver and set the source to the Galileo. Okay. So now I don't have to record arm this track. It's going to get its signal from whatever Galileo's getting its signal. In this case, my Key Rig 49. Okay, that's the whole point of the note receiver. So now if I play, it's interesting because the note receiver is just getting the MIDI information from Galileo, which is getting its information from my keyboard. Okay, and that's all I've done so far. So now what we want to do is be able to play chords on this, like for example, something like this. Well, that's a terrible sound. Something like this. Right? And take the bottom note only and feed it into this guy. Okay? One thing I might do, just because this is the sound of this instrument is terrible down here. Right? Like, that is horrible. So what I'm actually going to do is just throw a quick doobity-ba-ba-dum. What is it called? Is it this guy? Yeah. And I'm just going to bump it up an octave. Okay. So don't worry about that. I just had to do that because this instrument sounds like shit when it's played lower. So basically on this track, I might want to play some chords. right? And feed the bass line into that track. So we're basically done with this track, and let's look at this one. So the first thing I might do is put an arpeggiator on this. So I'll go into note effects and I'll load up an arpeggiator, okay? And I'm gonna bring the velocity of all of these following ones down to zero. So basically, as I play a note, it's just getting the first note and nothing else. Okay, I'm gonna turn this down to a one out of one, which is a bar length, and that up to a dotted quarter note. So let's see now. If I play a chord, right, let me show you what I'm actually playing. Doobie-doop-boo. Look, I'm playing a chord, it's right here, but you're only hearing that note. Right? Interesting. Because the reason that's happening is because an arpeggiator, when it has, you know, something like this, it will play the notes broken up. I'm sure you know that. But what I've done is tell it that after it plays the first note, don't play anything else by setting this velocity. And then I've gone and lengthened how long that note will play by putting this on a bar length and a dotted quarter note. Okay? So that's basically that. Now, the issue is if I play with my right hand, I'm still getting that. And that's not a bass sound. I don't want that at all. So what I'm going to do now is right in between the arpeggiator and the polysynth inside the note effects kind of box here, I'm going to put a note filter. Okay. So now I'm going to choose, if I'm playing the keyboard with both hands, okay, I'm going to choose a note that is in between both those hands that my left hand will likely never reach, okay? So in this case, if I'm playing, let's see, two A minor chords, one A minor starts on A3 and the other starts on A1, I might choose like the D3, okay? So now I'm going to take this maximum key and bring it down until I can't hear it. Okay, so D3 is note number 74. And so now basically what I've done is set it so that on my keyboard, any notes I play below D3, you can hear. Any notes I play above D3 don't make it through, see? Right. Okay, so now if I enable both tracks, let's equalize this volume a little, let's double click here. Now theoretically I should be able to play chords on this track and feed only the low note into the bass line, and I'll explain why it's not a perfect system. I'll show you that in a sec. Oh, the other thing that I did before I continue, and this is super important, is on the bass line or on the bass instrument, I put it on mono. Okay, that means that it's not playing multiple chords. It's not playing multiple notes. It'll only play one note at a time. Sorry, this is confusing. Okay. All right, let's see if this worked out. Okay, well, it seemed to have worked out. So let's turn this up so you can really hear the bass compared to the rest of the chords. Pretty cool. And then if we switch it around here, you can hear that I'm playing full chords on Galileo. Right, so there, now let's explain the limitations. So we've halfway achieved what we wanted, and because the way this works with mono is it's gonna take the note you play first. So if I play an A minor chord on my left hand, it depends what note I nail first. Let's open this up. So if I, even by a fraction of a millisecond, play the C note first when I play the chord, that's the one that's gonna be held, watch. Right? If I play this note first, that's the one that's gonna be held. hard to do. Even if it's just a fraction of a second. So basically, what I have to do is make sure that I'm always playing the bottom note first with my left hand, which isn't too much of a big deal. It's just, it's gonna shape the way you play the keyboard a little bit. But for me, I don't find it all that difficult. I kind of just make sure I'm hammering that A note first. And you can do it just by a fraction of a millisecond, just by making sure that finger is lower towards the keyboard. Right? So that's one limitation there. The other limitation is that this is going to determine how long you can hold that note for. So I can hold this chord, and if I keep holding it, at some point, it turns itself off because it wants to go to the next note in the sequence, but I've turned those velocities down, so you won't hear them. If I were to leave this up, then it would play the next note, and that's not what I want. So those are a couple of the limitations here, but by all intensive purposes, I am getting an effect where I can play chords on my one keyboard and the following bass track is picking up only the bottom note. Right? Okay, so useful in some ways, not so useful in other ways. So Troy, I know this isn't a perfect solution. I hope this gets you a little bit further to what you're trying to achieve here. And if anyone else watching this video has any more suggestions or ideas on how we can perfect the system, then I would really like for you to comment or email me and let us know. Let's help out our brother Troy here. He's a faithful subscriber and a good man, and he deserves your help. Okay, all right, I hope that did something for you. And if it did, maybe you'll subscribe. Maybe you're already a subscriber. And if that's the case, thank you. And I'll see you in the next video. I'm happy to be back. I can't wait to start uploading a little bit more for you. Okay, kids, take care.